Hello everyone, this is EC252, that is Digital Electronic Circuit, and today we will start with chapter 6, that is Resistor and Counter. Okay, so in this we will do some circuits which can store something which is called resistor, and also another type of circuit which can count. It can be up count or down count, but it can be count, it can be counted, so that is called counter. Now these two type of circuit we will study. First coming with that, whatever we do with sequential circuit, clock sequential circuit, flip flop is an essential circuit. Flip flop is essential component because flip flop can store something, so it acts as a memory component. So we know that in any kind of sequential circuit, okay, so any kind of sequential circuit, that means there should be some memory component, and this memory component will store some digit. For example, flip flop, it store a single digit information. It generally store in the form of Q and Q bar, that is Q and Q bar. So Q bar is generally the reverse, that means the complement of Q. So whatever we do, whatever the value of Q, that opposite or complement is Q bar, so it is storing one single bit information, that is acting as a memory element. Circuits that include flip flop are usually classified by the function they perform. Two such circuits are resistor and counter. Resistor and counter we are going to study. An n bit resistor consists of a group of n flip flop capable of storing n bit of binary information. So each bit store each single, so n bit store n bit. Now coming to resistor, a resistor consists of a group of flip flop and gates that affect their transition. So generally flip flop hold the binary information, that means it's act like a storing device. The gates determine how the information is transformed into the resistor. Counters are a special type of resistor which can count something, increment or decrement, but it can be counted. A counter goes through a predetermined sequence of state. So when increasing, which step will be there, and when decreasing, which step will be there, it will be predetermined. And whenever counter continues, it goes like that. Now this is the first example of resistor. We can see it is consist of 1, 2, 3, 4 D flip flop, and we know that D flip flop, the input and output is same. So whatever we provide in input, the same thing is given in output. And here it is for storing 4 bit. So you can see it is written 4 bit resistor. So that's why 4 D flip flop is used. Now we can see I0 is given to the input of first D flip flop. The output of first D flip flop is A0. The input of second D flip flop is I1. Output is A1. Like that, I2, I3, A2, A3 for the last two. So whenever these data are given, it will be stored in D flip flop, because D flip flop input and output is same. So whatever the value is given, that is I0, I1, I2, I3, they will store in D flip flop, and the the output will have the same. Now in every D flip flop there is one clock input, so as per the clock the flip flop will act. So it is a synchronous circuit, it is acting with respect to clock. So this four clock is given to all the clock input of D flip flop, and this four is given as clear. So whenever clear input will be given, the data in all the four D flip flop will be erased. So it is written that figure 6.1 shows a register constructed with 4 data flip flop. Clock triggers all flip flop on the positive edge of each pulse. If the symbol is like this, okay, it is positive edge triggered. What is not written that if we are having a bubble here, it indicates it's a negative edge flip-flop, but this is the example of positive edge flip-flop. Clear is useful for clearing the register to all zeros prior to its clock operation. For all the inputs, all the D flip flop to be cleared by this clear input. Next coming register with parallel load. So let's first take the diagram. We can see there is one input load. Okay. Now if the value of load is 1, suppose if it is 1, after NOT gate it is 0, and again after NOT gate it is again 1. So this 0 is going to here, so its output is 0. Okay, it is again going to here, so its output is 0. It is again going to here, so its output is 0, and it is going to here also, so here the output is 0. So we can see all the four D flip flop having the input from this OR gate. This for first, this for second, third, fourth. So if this OR gate is giving the input to the D flip flop. Now every OR gate having two input. Now if load is 1, we can see all the top AND gate its output is 0. So whatever the value of other AND gate, that is counted. Now let's see what is the output of other AND gate. Now as it is 1, so this is 1, this is 1, this is 1, this is 1. So if AND gate 1 input is 1, whatever the other input, that will determine the output of AND gate. Now this is I0, so here output will be I0. So 0 plus I0, here output will be I0. So this will go to input of first D flip flop. This is I1, so again this is I1. So again this is I1, Similarly, this is I2. So this is I2. This is I2. This is I2. This is I3. So I3, I3, I3. So we can see if load is 1, I0 is loaded to first flip flop, I1 is loaded to second flip flop, I2 is loaded to third flip flop, and I3 is loaded to fourth flip flop. So that means load operation is done when load is 1. This is because for this 4 upper AND gate, if one input is 0, output will obviously be 0, and for OR gate 0 does not matter. If one input is, because OR gate does addition, so if one input is 0, as we can see the upper input is 0, whatever will be the other input, that will determine. So in this case, this all the inputs I0, I1, I2, I3 will be loaded to the all the D flip flop. So this is the load operation, and we can say it is parallel load because all the data, that is I0, I1, I2, I3, all these are loaded simultaneously. Next, we'll see if our load is 0. We just see if the load is 1. So if the load is 1, all this data is loaded. If the load is 0, so this value is 1 after NOT gate, this value is 0 after NOT gate, another NOT gate. So if this is 0, it is going here, that means this is 0. It is again going here, 0 is going here, so it is again 0. This 0 is again going here, so it is 0, and this 0 is again going here, so it is 0. Now we can see just the opposite case, that means previously all the upper AND gate was 0, output was 0. Now all the lower AND gate output is 0. Okay, and this is 1. So this is 1, this is 1, this is 1, this is 1. In AND gate, 1 as an input don't have priority, because whatever the other input, that will be counted, because AND is multiplication operation. So 1 into something, that something will be, whatever multiplied by 1, that one will be the output. So let's see, whatever the input is, this is A0. That means 1 into A0, it will be A0. 0 plus A0, it will be A0. This is A1 multiplied by 1, it is A1. Added to 0, this is A1. This is A2 multiplied with 1, this is A2, and this output of OR gate is A2. This is A3 multiplied with 1, A3, OR with 0, A3. So now the input of all the D flip flop is, first input A0, second input A1, third input A2, fourth input A3. So whatever the data was previously, the same thing is stored only. The previous data, that means A0, A1, A2, A3, again is feedback to the D flip flop, and again the output is same. So it will simply store. So if load is 0, it will simply store. If load is 1, it will load whatever the data are there. the description is written, the clock input, this is C input, that is clock input, the clock is given. So this, it is telling of figure 6.1, so it will load the 4 input in parallel. Now coming to synchronism, it is advisable to control the operation of the register with D input rather than controlling the clock in the C input of the flip flop. A 4 bit register with a load control input that is directed through gates and into the D inputs of the flip flop is shown in figure 6.2. So this we just see, we have seen this how it is working. The description is written when the load inputs is 1, we have just seen this. The data in the 4 input are transferred into the register with next positive edge of the clock. When the load input is 0, the output of the flip-flop are connected to the respective inputs. We have seen the feedback connected from the output to input is necessary because D flip-flop does not have a no change condition, so it have to give a input. Now shift register. Shift register means it just shifts. Okay, so whatever the value is here, it will be shifted. A register capable of shifting the binary information in one or both directions is called a shift register. All flip flops receive common clock pulses which activate the shift from one stage to the next. The simplest possible shift register is one that uses only flip-flop, only with flip-flop, and it is giving in the next diagram 6.3. So we can see the clock is given to the all C input of the D flip-flop. This is the serial input. So whatever the first serial input, that is the first data, after first clock pulse it will go to here. After second clock pulse, it will go to here. After third clock pulse, it will go to here. After fourth clock pulse, it will be here. So like this, serially it will be shifted. Each clock pulse shifts the contents of the register one bit position to the right. The serial input determines what goes into the leftmost flip-flop during the shift. Whenever the data is fed from outside, it is given by the serial input this, and whatever given here, it is just shifted to the output. The serial input determines on what goes into the leftmost flip-flop during the shift. The serial output is taken from the output of the rightmost flip-flop. Output is serial output. Next, serial transfer. A digital system is said to operate in a serial mode when information is transferred and manipulated one bit at a time. So we have just seen parallel load, all the inputs are loaded parallelly. Now if we do any operation one bit at a time, it is called serial. This is contrast to parallel transfer, where all the bits of the register are transferred at the same time. The serial transfer is done with shift register, which we will see in the next block diagram. So this is clock input, this is shift control, both is ANDed. So that means when both the clock as well as the shift control is high, when both is high, that is logical 1, then this clock 2 signal will be operated. And shift register A, we can see it will be circularly shifted to the right, and sink resistor B will take the output of sink resistor A, and it will shift right, and the rightmost bit will be out as serial output. To prevent loss of information stored in the source register, the information in register A is made to circulate by connecting the serial output to its serial input. The shift control input determines when and how the shift control input, this we have seen, ANDed with the clock signal, determines when and how many times the register are shifted. This is done with an AND gate that allows clock pulses to pass into the clock terminals only when shift control is active. We can see in this diagram that whenever shift control is high, because it is ANDed, so it will be multiplied. So this is when 1, only that time whenever this is 1, it is multiplied and we are having the output. For serial transfer, the shift control signal is synchronized with the clock and changes value just after the negative edge of the clock. Each rising edge of the pulse causes a shift in both registers. The fourth pulse changes the shift control to 0 and the shift register are disabled. Here we can see after 4, as this signal is 0, multiplied with anything will be 0. That is written after fourth pulse changes the shift control to 0 and the shift register are disabled. So as we have seen that shift register has a circular right shifting, so we can see there is only 0, so that we can point out easily. It is shifted right, it is circularly, here and here shifting right every time circularly. So after it is 4 bits, so after 4 change, 1 change, 2 change, 3 change, 4 change, 4th time change, the same data is here after 4 clock pulse, and shift register B is just right shifted. So whatever may be the initial value does not matter. After first clock, the rightmost will come here and it will be here, and the other three digits, this digit will be out and these three digit will be shifted right again. Next, this is the input to the shift register B, so this will be inputted and whatever the last bit will go, and it is 100, this will come here. Again, the 0 will be input to shift register B and rightmost will go outside, and remaining 110, this will be here. This one will be here. The rightmost will go to outside, and this 011 will be here. So after 4 clock pass, we can see the initial value 1011 of shift register A stored is here as well as here. serial transfer. In the parallel mode, information is available from all bits, can be transferred simultaneously during one clock pulse. For parallel, only one clock pulse is needed, but for serial, how many bits, that many clock pulse is needed. In the serial mode, the registers have a single serial input and a single serial output. The information is transferred one bit at a time while the registers are shifted in the same direction. This is. Okay. Now, serial addition. Operations in digital computers are usually done in parallel because it is a faster mode of operation. Serial operations are slower but have the advantage of requiring less equipment. So we have to trade off between these two. If we need fast, we go to parallel. If we need less equipment, we go to serial. The two binary numbers to be added serially are stored in two shift registers. Bits are added one pair at a time through a single full adder. This can be given in this diagram. So shift register A, the sum is stored and clock and shift control is here. So when both clock and shift control is high, when clock is high, that is with synchronizing with clock, shift register A will operate. Now when shift control is also high, it will shift to right side. So whatever the input, that will go to right side, and whatever the sum, that will be stored from the left side. And serial input, it is given here, it is also shifted right side, and the serial output will be the second input of full adder, and whatever the carry, it is stored in a D flip flop, and the output of D flip flop is stored as the third input of full adder, and all this sum is stored in shift register A, carry again to this D flip flop. And both this shift control and clock are ANDed and given to this clock signal of this D flip flop, so that whenever any carry is generated, it can be stored in this D flip flop. So up to now, we have seen how these flip flop and some gates can be make some circuit which can store something which is called registers and how they operates. We will continue. Thank you.